Hi lads and lasses, Modest Pelican here with Hitman 3. If you enjoy this video, please reserve every other seat in the cinema under the name Modest Pelican so there will be no premarital handholding, as this really helps spread the good word of my channel. I've been playing Hitman games for as long as I can remember. I love the classic formula of picking a suitable loadout, exploring the location, finding all the booties on the map, stalking your targets, and then carefully executing a job only to jump on YouTube the next day and watch someone complete the entire game in 7 minutes and 5 seconds with a perfect silent assassin rating. What a king. Today's mission is a little different, however. We'll be infiltrating a German nightclub owned by a motorcycle gang to eliminate 5 unknown targets. We also can't bring any gadgets or weapons with us. Not ideal, but on the positive side, I do have a phone. No reception though, so Agent 47 can't even message the boys' group chat asking for some encouraging words. I assume he has a group chat with the other genetically enhanced assassins. Instead, I message my actual group chat for some inspiring sentiment and the lads replied. Carbo complimented my peenie, Fieldo made fun of me for being incredibly allergic to gluten, Marto told me my sex life was deader than my channel, and Robbo said my smile makes his pee-pee rise. That's all the motivation I need, let's go find this nightclub and get killing. There she is, and it seems like they've done this really original cool underground thing of turning an abandoned industrial warehouse into a venue. I bet rather than having normal seats, it's just upside down milk crates. Revolutionary shit. The only other thing I know about our targets is that they are other assassins who have been sent here to kill me. I stumble across one who is speaking incredibly loudly through his earpiece and using a bright torch. What a professional. Bald on bald crime is a growing concern. I take his earpiece and his silenced pistol. That's one target down, 4 to go. I can now hear the other agents communicating, and it seems they're all undercover somewhere inside the venue. They could be staff, security, guests, I don't really know. It's time to find and eliminate these dodgy malakas. The place is incredibly busy and reminds me of a club I went to when I was in Ibiza. One of my mates disappeared with a girl, and then 3 hours later we found him in the smoking area being cradled like a baby by a giant tattooed man who clearly abused steroids. My mate was giving him relationship advice and he got quite emotional, it was a real curveball. The queue is long, but I'm obviously not going to push in front of anyone, as this is a society. Plus, you guys know I'm all about that realistic gameplay experience. If I have to wait in the line for 2 hours and then convince a group of girls to pretend to be friends with me so the bouncer actually lets me in, then that's just immersive. Kidding, I push through to the front and then get rejected entry as expected. In their defense, I don't exactly look like a good time. In fact, I look exactly like an assassin who is going to kill people. I need to find another access point, but security here is tight. In the car park, I spot some guy pacing nervously, and when I approach him, he asks if I can help find his allergy pills. That's really sad that his allergies are playing up when he's trying to be social, so of course I'm going to help the poor sick man. It's a medical emergency. He said he cycled here, so I begin checking all the bikes. Sure enough, in one of the baskets, I find his pills. Weird. This sign in German says, like Modest Pelican's video, no geese. And pretty cool, so thanks for including an Easter egg for me, IO Interactive. I run back to Mr. Sniffles, who honestly has a really bad strategy for searching for his belongings. He appreciates my assistance and says he'll get me in for free. Nothing beats the common cold like double dropping. Phase 1 complete, we have infiltrated the nightclub. I have also made a new best friend forever, Mr. Sniffles. As Agent 47 is a clone that was bred in a lab, I imagine it's hard for him to connect with people, so this is a pretty wholesome moment. They insist on frisking me, which is some shameless racial profiling. I have to go and ditch my gun in the car park, and then I get in no problem. To my pleasant surprise, Mr. Sniffles actually waits for me, what a G. He even offers to give me a tour. I feel like I'm living in an alternate universe where Vass from Far Cry 3 never began kidnapping natives and selling them into slavery, and instead drank vodka sodas and socially smoked. We descend deeper into the building, with the music growing louder and louder. There she is, Club Hole, which translates to Club Hell in English. This guy here has the kind of energy I envy. I wonder how he's managing to be so lively at 3 a.m. in the morning. It's either a balanced diet of many fresh fruits and vegetables, or several grams of coke. We finish the tour on the dance floor, and I've gotta say, the architecture of this mission is incredibly impressive. I still haven't seen anyone who looks like like they could be one of my targets, so I decide to hit the dance floor to properly scope out the area. Since you can't actually dance in this game, I decide to do an impression of one of my mates. He's an absolute legend and a big unit in great shape, he's got funny banter amongst the boys, I absolutely love him. When it comes to getting girls, however, this guy would not only cock block himself, he'd cock block every guy in the same hemisphere as him. When I was 18 and wanting to meet girls, I just accept that if he was coming out with us that night, I might as well wear a fedora and a cape. For example, you'd spot him in a club. Everyone else is moving, having a good time, and he'd just be standing there with his mouth gaping, staring into the souls of women. Even I was scared, it was the creepiest shit, and everyone would slowly move away from him. This man would dry up a room faster than Viva paper towels. Use code PELLY when you next purchase paper towels from Viva. Nah, kidding, I don't have a paper towel code, and they didn't sponsor this video. But Viva, I just plugged your shit, so please send me some money, or at least a few rolls. Anyway, there's a DJ up in the booth shredding the decks and pressing the skip button on Spotify ads. I know I'm here to assassinate people, but I have a new goal. I want to become the DJ. I explore some of the bar areas trying to find some kind of lead. 47 blends seamlessly into his surroundings and definitely doesn't look like a sober serial killer. I run into my friend again, who despite giving me a well-rounded and honestly quite charismatic tour of the establishment not 5 minutes ago, doesn't even remember who I am. Pretty hurtful, but hitmen don't cry in public. They cry in the shower when they get home. I catch one of the employees leaving the storeroom, so I sneak inside. There's fresh fruit and also a sink left in a disgusting state. Do you know how many germs are on a dish sponge? This place needs to stop pushing so many narcotics and focus on their health and safety procedures. I grab some rat poison and a coconut and then wait for a bartender to come in. I then throw it at his head but completely miss. Honestly pretty embarrassing, but at least it distracted him and we can now take his clothing. I love the clothes the staff wear here. It's like, hey, we might commit an act of mass terror, but we're going to look cute as heck while we do it. I decide to tend bar, and given I have absolutely no intel to go on, I figure I might as well poison this guy's drink. I mean, he's got a turtleneck, Archer's got a turtleneck, that's good enough for me, this man might be a spy. Not a great one, as I'm not exactly hiding what I'm up to. He skulls it, and sure enough, it makes him feel pretty sick. I follow him to the bathroom, which is not secluded at all. I forgot that this is where everyone takes all their allergy pills. My guy goes into a cubicle and straight up throws up on some dude's lap. I hate it when you need to throw up but you don't notice someone is sitting on the toilet first. If I had a nickel. I continue exploring and spot some guy in a red bucket hat with a big black coke, aka a dealer. I ask him if he has anything and he gets me to follow. As soon as you register to become a dealer down at the job center, they give you a bucket hat as part of your welcome bonus. He asks me for some money, which is apparently a key part of this kind of transaction. I panic and choke him to death. I also briefly become him and live out my dream of being a nightclub dealer. I'm going to revolutionize the industry by saying please, thank you, and not stabbing people on tick. I get back into my timeless pink balaclava and sneak backstage. I spot a DJ off shift and realize now is my moment. I smack him over the head with a wrench. I have now completed the most important part of being a DJ. I'm wearing a strange, memorable outfit. I head into the booth and the crowd is pumped. At this point of the night, I could probably put on Thomas the Tank Engine theme song and these guys would be happy. And this is pretty cool, but I genuinely thought by doing all of this, I would have found one of my targets by now. I drop the bass and then do something I really didn't want to have to do. Critical thinking. I learn the club is controlled by a motorcycle gang known as the Disciples. They seem to have a restricted clubhouse area out the back. I then hit the staff laundry room and find a security disguise which should give me access to all areas. Even the bloody security outfits are edgy with their little folded beanies. I can't tell if I'm meant to check IDs or change my Insta bio to creative director of a crypto startup. I figure a good assassin would be up high surveying the situation, so I head up to the top level. Sure enough, I overhear one of the tech guys talking loudly into his earpiece, which has really been the Achilles heel for these guys. It's time to start taking calculated risks, so I grab a fire extinguisher and start knocking everyone unconscious. I then drag the bodies to a secluded location before anyone can see. Our agent friend had a silenced SMG on him, and so I go and put the big dog to sleep for good. When this woman wakes up next to a corpse riddled with bullets, she's going to be absolutely horrified. She'll probably need counseling for the rest of her life, making this a certified epic prank. Two targets eliminated. I head back outside as I need to find a way into this motorcycle clubhouse, as one of my targets is surely hiding out there. While sneaking around, some guy who looks exactly like an undercover cop almost spots me. He then begins basically screaming into his earpiece that he's one of the assassins. Their situational awareness is worse than mine. I begin stalking him through some sort of outdoor smoking area that I believe is built right next to open sewerage. So cool and underground. Soon they'll be opening nightclubs in war-torn countries that are so exclusive you'll literally have to enlist in the army, get deployed, and then go AWOL just to attend. I learn the big dog's route and throw my wrench to lure him over. I do a sneaky lap and put several bullets straight into his upper back for cinematic effect. This turns out to be a highly questionable decision as several other people heard the bullet impact. Fortunately, I hide the body just in time. 3 targets down, 2 to go. At last, I find the Disciples clubhouse, and hopefully I can find the president, the VP, or at least the sergeant at arms. I need to have a stern chat to them about their health and safety procedures, as what I've seen today is quite frankly disgusting. I'm not allowed back here as a security guard, which is a promising sign that there's some shady business going on. To add even more pressure to the mission, Agent 47's ears are rapidly getting colder. I spot a member burning toys, which seems like unnecessary wastage. Sure, they were likely used to smuggle coke across the border, but if you gave them a thorough rinse, you could definitely give them to charity or something. Motorcycle gangs are so thoughtless sometimes. I change into his clothes, but before I can move the body, another member approaches. There's no time to do anything clever, so I just unload half a clip into his chest. It turns out the big girl was one of my targets. Subconsciously calculated, I guess. He was probably just doing his job, being instructed by a higher up. I get it, you've got to put food on the table and feed your kids. I proceed to incinerate his body so that said kids will forever wonder what happened to him. I continue exploring the clubhouse and they're mostly just smuggling narcotics, how predictable. I locate a weed plantation and these guys are so unprofessional, there's not nearly enough artificial light in here. Trust me, I know I'm a YouTuber who doesn't go outside very much. I know my artificial light. Much like his comrades before him, he yells into his earpiece, completely blowing his cover. Imagine the effort he went to infiltrating this gang, only to blow it all because he forgot to whisper. I expose a power cord, flood the floor, and then lure him around to check out what's going on. I could have just shot him, but much like the people who attend this nightclub, I'm a misunderstood artist. Surprisingly, I didn't kill one person that wasn't a target on this mission, and it may genuinely be the first time that's ever happened. Mission complete, and we earn a 3-star rating, which seems harsh, but fair, I guess. A new RP video is up on the Papa Pelly channel. Make sure to join the Discord and follow me on Twitter. Thanks for watching, you legends, and until next time, and as always, stay classy.